you, Madam Speaker. I rise to ask question 8 of 2018 under my name, and the question is directed to the Honourable Minister for Agriculture, Rural and Maritime Development, and National Disaster Management and Meteorological Services. As the high-level champion for COP23, can the Minister explain to this House the role of the Marcus Partnership for Global Climate Action? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. I now give the floor to the Honourable Minister for Agriculture, Rural and Maritime Development, Disaster Management and Meteorological Services. You have the floor.
Point of order.
Clarification on the Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action, or is it Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action? In the question is KESH, but the name is Marrakesh, KECH, the last four, Partnership for Global Climate Change. In that respect, Madam Speaker, whether this question can go forward or you wait till another.
Correct.
I think the putting a spelling error aside, there's an understanding that we were referring to the same partnership. Thank you. Honourable Minister for Culture, Rural and Maritime Development, Disaster Management, Meteorological Services, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Whether it's Marrakesh or Marrakesh, climate change affects everybody. We are all in the same canoe, Madam Speaker, and I thank the Honourable Member for the question. Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action, Madam Speaker, was launched in 2016 during the COP22. Yes, of course, in Marrakesh, CH, in Morocco. Madam Speaker, let me give a bit of background to this. The decisions emerging from the UNFCCC Conference of the Parties in 2015 recognized the important role that the non-state or sometimes called the non-party stakeholders play in achieving the objectives of the Paris Agreement. I think this is an important thing that we should all know, especially all honorable members of this House. In the implementation of the Paris Agreement, we have parties and we have the non-party stakeholders. COP is Conference of the Parties. And the parties are those that ratified the Paris Agreement, and they include our national governments. In Fiji's instance, government ratified the Paris Agreement, and government has committed to reduction of global warming through lowering carbon emission through its NDCs. And this morning we've been talking about mitigation and adaptation and of course resilience as well. And mostly the big components of our NDCs, nationally determined contributions, is mainly on mitigation, because more mitigation now means lesser adaptation in the future. And of course we are small emitters, but we still have a role to play, and we have made our commitments. Likewise, Madam Speaker, when it comes to the implementation of the Paris Agreement, it's not only the parties that are going to implement the Paris Agreement. Majority or most of the emission, Madam Speaker, comes from the non-party stakeholders. And I'll give example from businesses, the private sector, from cities and towns, the various industries that I will talk about later on, Madam Speaker. So, the recognition of the role that the non-party stakeholders play in the implementation of the Paris Agreement. Madam Speaker, what led to this? Madam Speaker, let me say, particularly as from a small island developing state, that it was on the insistence of small island developing states that led to decision 121, if I remember correctly, of the Paris Agreement, which mandated the presidencies of the COP to appoint what we call the global climate champions. And this year it's between Fiji and Poland. And it's the role of the global climate champions, Madam Speaker, to coordinate the efforts of the non-party stakeholders in the implementation of the Paris Agreement. But let me talk more about the Marrakesh partnership itself. I mentioned, Madam Speaker, that in the implementation of NDCs, it's not only parties, it's not only governments. Most of the implementation is from the non-party stakeholders. Majority of the emissions, Madam Speaker, that occur within our environment takes place from the non-party stakeholders. And therefore, to ensure that there is a coordinated approach and of course guided by a framework, the framework was the one that was established in November 2016 during COP22, and the two global champions then were from France and of course Morocco, Madam Speaker, and they have put in place the Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action. Madam Speaker, as I've alluded to, the Marrakesh Partnership gives effect to the agreed outcomes in the Paris Agreement by providing a structured and coherent framework for the UNFCCC process to accelerate the scale and pace of climate action. And UNFCCC, Madam Speaker, refers to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Madam Speaker, the Marrakesh Partnership involves national and subnational governments, civil society, financial institutions, investors, cities, local communities, and of course the private sector. And the partnership provides a platform for sharing experiences, working together, and multiplying effects. And this includes assistance in the delivery of finance, technology, and capacity building. Talking about subnational governments, Madam Speaker, a perfect example would be the United States. The federal government has decided to come out of the Paris Agreement, but that legally will take place after 4 years. But yet the subnational governors are still committed to the Paris Agreement. And that is one beautiful aspect of the non-party stakeholders' involvement in the Paris Agreement. And they have an initiative called the We Are Still Here initiative that's still focused on the implementation of the Paris Agreement. But to cut it short, Madam Speaker, I'll just touch on the seven thematic areas. Why the seven thematic areas? When you look at emission all over the world, and particularly amongst the non-party stakeholders, about 80% of the emission comes from these areas. And I will end here, Madam Speaker. One is on land use. And of course, agriculture. We have made some progress. The Honorable Prime Minister will speak on it today. But agriculture is a problem, but of course, it is a big solution as well. Land use, covering agriculture, forest, and other land use are covered under land use. And of course, we have oceans and coastal zones, and we have water, human settlements, transport, energy, and energy. So these are the seven thematic areas that contribute about 80% of the global warming, and this is where the focus of the Marrakesh Partnership is. And they are organized into coalitions and initiatives, and of course under the framework and the Secretariat of the UNFCCC and the champions, guided by the champions, we are working towards the commitment of parties in the NDCs and how it can be enhanced through the participation of non-party stakeholders. That is basically what the Marrakesh Partnership for Global Climate Action is all about. And you would have seen it in the Bonn Zone, and of course the Honorable Dulag Barata in Germany, the involvement of the non-party stakeholders. Thank you, Madam Speaker.